So Brian, Westpac today announced it's increasing variable mortgage rates. Can you talk us through how you approached the decision, given I can imagine it's probably been a pretty difficult one?
Yeah, these decisions are always difficult, particularly when you're impacting the cost of living for people, and we're very conscious of that. We recognize that part of our job is to accept the volatility that comes in financial markets around our funding costs. And so when wholesale borrowing costs started rising back in February, we absorbed that and we took the view that hopefully the elevated costs would go back down. And unfortunately they haven't, and they continued to rise. And we've come to the conclusion that what we're looking at is a sustained increase in that key benchmark wholesale funding cost rate. It's now been elevated for over 6 months. There's always a little bit of volatility, but we've concluded when we look at what's happening in markets that it's going to stay up there. And so reluctantly, we came to the conclusion that that needed to be reflected in our mortgage costs.
And banks obviously have to manage, I guess, various stakeholders. How have you gone about approaching this time around, given the external environment? I mean, there's quite a lot of inquiries going on. The industry is facing a bit of scrutiny.
Yes, well, ultimately, this is a decision about funding costs. And we acknowledge that it's a very difficult environment for banks. I mean, you can imagine that making a decision like this at this time is not something that we relished. But nevertheless, I have to run the business for the long term, and part of that is reflecting the reality of our funding costs.
And so the earnings benefit doesn't fully offset the pressure?
Well, we haven't sought to recover the cost that we've been wearing over the last 6 months. So this increase is prospective. It really only affects the mortgages from here. So that cost over the last 6 months of higher funding is something we've essentially absorbed.
Yeah, so let's go to that wholesale funding cost issue, because like you say, it has been around for some months now. What's been driving it?
Well, there are a variety of things. The number that we're particularly focused on here is what's called the bank bill swap rate, the BBSW. That's essentially the rate at which banks borrow among themselves for 90 days. And when we think about how we benchmark the interest rate for variable rate mortgages, we look to that 90-day rate as that basis. Now, what's happened is a couple of things. In particular, the increase in interest rates offshore has meant that foreign banks that operate in this market have found it cheaper to borrow locally rather than borrow offshore and send the money down here. That's increased the competition, if you like, for the available funds in the Australian market, and that's pushed rates up. There's a couple of other factors, but that's certainly one of the main ones.
Yeah, I think the RBA has spoken about cash actually moving back to the US too with the tax changes.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that's probably an important point to make as well, because people often look to the Reserve Bank for what they're doing with interest rates, and the Reserve Bank makes a decision on the cash rate, which is essentially a short-term risk-free rate. That's not the rate that we borrow at. That's an input to what ultimately drives interest rates, but the borrowing rate that's relevant for mortgages is more that 90-day bank bill swap rate.
So let's put some numbers around this, because big banks in Australia, roughly 60-odd% of their funding is actually deposits, and the bulk of the rest is from wholesale funding markets.
Yes.
So have you seen, going forward, do you think this pressure might flow into the deposit market?
Rates have already increased on deposits, and that reflects the fact that wise banks are very focused on making sure that their funding is stable and that most of their funding does come from deposits. But Australia has a current account deficit, and one of the consequences of that is that the major Australian banks do import capital from overseas to help fund our lending for homeowners and businesses. And so we are exposed to more of a wholesale borrowing cost, both in that domestic market as well as some of our offshore funding costs. From time to time, people who've observed this over the years would know that different aspects of our funding mix can change in cost at different times. Sometimes there was more competition for deposits when new regulation was brought in that required banks to hold more deposits and more liquid assets. That had an impact on deposit pricing. Sometimes when they're in the GFC, we saw a big increase in the credit borrowing cost offshore for wholesale for Australian banks. This phenomenon seems to be more about the domestic wholesale borrowing competition.
Right, yeah. So just lastly, back on the asset side, are you concerned at all that this move might put a bit more stress, I guess, on homeowners at a time when the housing market has slowed?
Well, we're certainly conscious of the impact on the cost of living for consumers. But from a credit point of view, no, I'm not concerned about the stress aspect. I mean, while acknowledging that it is an increase in cost, about two-thirds of our mortgage holders are paid ahead on their mortgages, so that gives them a significant buffer already. When we approve a loan, we factor in a significant buffer of higher interest rates when we do the calculations of what loans we can approve. And very importantly, even after this increase in rates, interest rates for our customers are still below what they were 3 years ago. So it is an increase, but rates have come down substantially in the last few years. This moves it back toward that rate, but still below that. The other thing I should say here is we know it's a competitive market, and a number of the regional banks have already repriced their mortgages reflecting these same costs. So this is not limited to just the big banks. But notwithstanding the increase, our rates will still be lower than most of those regional bank rates will be after these changes.
Brian, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for your time.